Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.
Man, 42. That's getting into the fuck it years.
Wait, what?
My age.
Oh, that you're 42 years old?
Yeah, yeah. A little closer.
Wait,
to...
What do you mean, fuck it years? You're like in the prime.
Well, I mean, yeah. I guess, you know what it is when I was in my late 30s is when I discovered Smodcast, and Kevin Smith had all these thoughts about being turning 40 and calming down and mellowing out. And it seems like by and large, his ambition to please the traditional Hollywood game has reduced. And every time I hear or see him doing anything, he seems happier than I've ever seen him. And now, through the time travel I like to call aging, I am experiencing a taste of that. And I don't know, it's pretty great. It's pretty great to be able to say no. Like, there was a phrase from the guy who wrote, the guy who created CD Baby. You know, one of his mantras is it's either hell yes or it's no. And being able to say no to things is I have always felt guilty saying no to anyone for anything. But that dividing line of, well, are you saying hell yes in your heart? And I'm like, well, I'm not. I'm like, well, then guess what? You answered. The answer is no. And then and even then I don't say no. I say, try me again in a month. You know, like, so that's, I don't know. That's where I'm at.
Yeah, man. I don't know exactly how much age numbers necessarily, like, I'm far more worried about what I'm doing between, like, now and 6 months from now and a year from now than I am, like, when, you know, worrying about how old I am.
Well,
yes. I'm 30, I'm going to be 34. But, so it's like, maybe this is like bullshit, low stakes, penny ante worrying about your aging until you get to 40 and 50. And now you're like really, really worried about stuff.
Well, but I guess also you spent most of your life I'm assuming, maybe I'm projecting here. But I suspect you spent most of your post-adolescent life thinking that whatever you did, it would be a career with a long path. I have always felt, have always had a low grade terror that by virtue of being on camera, by being on stage, by having an athletic, self-destructive show where I'm banging bricks over my head and all this stuff, I thought shelf life. I think that has driven me to always be diversifying so that when one part of me breaks, the system can keep on going. And to finally, at age 42, I feel between three podcasts, two YouTube channels, six videos a week, live shows touring, and bar mitzvahs, I feel like I am sufficiently diversified that I don't need to have low-grade panic at all times, and it feels really good. That's all I'm trying to say.
Well, that's good. No, totally. I mean, I think that
motherfucker, Judas! Judas! You've seen me at my worst and lowest!
I'm sorry. I'm glad you're not stressing out literally all the time, because you definitely were.
Yeah, no, that was rough, man. Those.
Hey, great show, everybody. What should we call it? We got a lot of different titles that came in from Twitch and from show, but let's see where we can get like the start of this. Mm. So the one on the left is chronological, and this one you can vote.
Jalurp Erso is very strong.
Jalurp Erso is pretty good. but unfortunately, you described it as the character Jin Erso was next to was named Jalurp.
Sure. But I mean, if we get emails like, that's actually bullshit because Jalurp was not an Erso, as yeah. You said in the
also,
middle of the show.
Also, for the record,
the seven sons Ersos.
Yeah. 40 describes a sizable chunk of the back catalog of previous episodes. That was
but
not
new.
You
only turned 42 once, Brian.
Okay, fine. Schwood turns 42.
42, I feel like, is a strong title.
2016 sucked. That's not too bad.
Oh, I was never. I'm sad that I had to break it into so many tweets. Like, none of them had the punch that I wanted. But this idea that the notion.
Although, right for the wrong reasons is also great.
That's fine. I'm good with that. Right for the wrong reasons is good. Or falling up a ladder.
there we go. That's it.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay. Thanks everybody for voting.
Like a genuine. Here, this is the funny shit. Is like, you know, 2016, terrible year, blah blah blah. But I had, you know, you do a little self-reflection, and especially, you know, you self-reflect when you're ill and when you have milestone moments. And I've been weirdly excited about the year 2017. I've been
falling up a ladder, falling Bryce, up, not falling
yeah,
down.
Yeah, no,
a ladder.
I screwed that up. Falling up. Falling up.
Sorry, that was very important. I corrected you.
Right. I saw it, and I was like, oh, I'm gonna get a million people saying.
But the but like.
Bryce, it's falling up a ladder, actually.
Oh, thank you for that.
If you can change that.
Spit take! So,
I held it in.
Like, man. 2016 really did teach me a lesson, and I wish I could have phrased it better, but the lesson it taught me is if you get second-degree burns, don't spend all year worrying about whether or not you're going to get scars, because at the end of the same year, your hand will get chopped up by a drone anyway.
What episode was it of Modern Rogue where, because you said something and it actually stuck with me, where you were supposed to cover your crotch from a cannon or some dumb thing you were doing.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. And
your
it was...
partner was like, yeah, protect the valuable stuff. And you're like, my hands are the valuable thing.
Yeah,
I'm
you
a
wouldn't
magician,
know it.
And that stuck with me.
Yeah, you wouldn't know it from 2016, man.
Yeah, well, because that was before the shit started happening to your hands. Because I remember.
Oh, no,
I
it was after.
I was like, oh, he's right. And
the then burn. It was like, no, the burn happened at the beginning of 2016.
Oh, really?
Because it was primary season. It was in February. And he had just done well in South Carolina. Because I had burns exactly. That
That's
made
right.
my hand puppet mouth became Donald Trump. Did you ever see this?
Was that the part of the year where we all still had a hope?
Yes. Yes.
No, that was – well, no. South Carolina is where it really started to barrel down. You know, that's where everything was –
when the NYT graph did this, like when they just crossed and you're like, those are the backwards of where those should be.
Well, I mean, let's just say this. For people who did not want Donald Trump to be president, South Carolina was the point in which everybody was saying, well, at least we have Hillary Clinton to stop him.
Yep.
which historically did not quite pan out.
Yeah. And you know what's
she
weird?
She did do that mannequin challenge in first class in an airplane with John Bon Jovi. A week and a half before the election. Nothing connects you to voters like that.
I mean, listen, considering you wind up losing by like 12 votes in four counties in like right. Michigan, Wisconsin, and Ohio, nothing will speak to him like Bon Jovi doing a millennial focus challenge in the first class of a plane. That's always.
Oh, hey, well, you know what?
It was the first class of her plane.
Her plane.
Well, and also she was only in the first classes because that's where the important people sit while they keep the rest of the press in the back.
Real quick, do we have any first timers who watched the show for the first time? I'm in love with this idea
that new people watch our show now.
Yeah, yes, quite literally. Because previous to being on Twitch, it was like that was a useless question. hello, congregation. I see we've all come back this week. I want to know.
I noticed a lot of new names when I was saying hello to everybody at the start of the pre-show.
Right on.
But I would hope we got some more.
Well, because also I think we have been like not only historically bad at bringing people up to speed or being an approachable show, but like accurate. Full on hostile, where it's just like, hey, fuck you. You didn't keep up. Why don't you eat my shit? You know, like that's what we do.
Start doing the quizzes just like that. I'm going to say it just
I remember
as you too. Now, just don't you. I'm going to fuck you up. You're going to eat shit. I'm Mike Newman. I'm going to beat you up.
Check me out.
Sothar 83. Apparently, was that was not a real 4chan.
Oh, we would have felt a tremor if there was a real earthquake.
Saying that's probably just some kid.
Yeah.
I mean, Sothar 83.
Take it from someone who's survived a magnitude 8.5 earthquake. Okay. You'd feel a tremor.
Did you ever hear about this, Mikey?
Don't entice them.
Oh yeah, did you ever know that I was the winner of a pedo bomb slash B game?
What?
Yeah, no. Like, we're recording the second comedy album, and I'm already stressed out as fuck because after 4 years, Scam School has had its first dust up with a subsection of magicians that felt like we crossed a line and we taught a trick that was too good. So I've been doing about a month's worth of having panic attacks and quietly talking, you know, hey, what are people upset about? Well, have you thought about this? All that stuff. And I'm like, you know, hey, going to go out to Amtrekker's wedding. We're going to record some comedy album tracks. It'll be great. In the middle of doing all that, just a tweet, random tweet said, heads up, slash B coming. And I was like, I don't know what that means. And then all of a sudden a couple tweets just like, dude, check your comments. And like, apparently behind the scenes, the discussion was, hey, we're going to pick a random person. Of course, it can't be personal because then it wouldn't be funny if it was personal. We're going to roll some dice. And if it comes up as this person, then for the lulz, we are going to make the whole world believe he, she, or it was arrested for pedophilia. And
that's terrible.
Should I have no reaction?
Should I pretend this is
No.
I really don't want this to happen.
Oh, no. It was to watch the comments come in was a harrowing experience because
thankfully
there are.
So just so you know, the way that they were going about it was by citing like specific details, and they were all doing it under different accounts, under different videos,
hundreds,
as if this was just a story that had broke somewhere, and now they were all flooding these comments. So that's Brian, shell of a man, Brushwood, up on my roof here in Oakland, California, looking out into the grand expanse of Lake Merritt. Now all of a sudden, also finding out that you can fall through the bottom of the basement of your self-esteem by having these random hooligans accuse him of being a pedophile.
But, and I mean this sincerely, and I've said this before personally, and I've said this before publicly, in my entire life, there are... You think this baby's day out routine that we did tonight was a miraculous run? Of all the places on this planet to be, when that happened, to be... on the rooftop next to Justin was the one place that could possibly save my career, save my life, and save my sanity. Because I, out of steam and with nothing, I just looked up at Justin with dead eyes, and I saw him become a general in a war room explaining to me the rules of engagement and what would and would not work. Here is what they want. Here is why they are doing it. This is a smart strategy on their part because literally nothing you say can undo it. If you say you love children, if you say you have children, you're fucked. You can't deny, you can't, you know, what are you going to do? And then finally, after giving a superior speech to that shitty movie Patton, I never saw it,
hashtag fuck Patton.
He pulls down the flag and he said, and the words I remember are him saying, the only way you survive this is if it becomes no longer fun for them. And so we sat and we thought, in about 20 minutes, they're like, what do we need to do? We need to, and I knew a little bit about dealing with hecklers and crowds or whatever, but it's like, they need to feel like it's no longer having an impact. They need to feel like they've been acknowledged and that people know what they're up to, but it cannot be an escalation. You cannot meet force with force. So instead, here, look up real quick. It says, I won the internet lottery, Scam School. In about two minutes.
Yeah, I think we shot and posted this video, and this was still at a point where there was maybe a nebulous question of...
Yeah,
of you uploading to that channel?
Of the appropriateness of me without consulting, talking to Discovery, or nothing at all. Like, just right. Like, nope, shut up, posting this, it's happening right now. Here, back it up, and then, yeah.
of a honest... Oh, hello, Internet. Today is a momentous occasion, because after 5 years and nearly 300 episodes of Scam School, we've finally gotten big enough to attract the attention of 4chan. That's right, 4chan, that lovable group of rapscallions who stir up trouble on the Internet. And today, I was the lucky lottery winner of a honest-to-goodness slash B pedo bomb. This is where everyone gets together. Give me my award. I won it fair and square. There we go. Boom. That's a slash B champion right there. So they come in and everyone calls you a pedophile. But here's the important thing, and I mean this sincerely. Thank you, because we need the views very, very badly. Big, big fan. The views, great. Pedophile comments, not so great. But the views, I'm okay with. I want to thank 4chan for considering me. I want to thank ChatRealm for marking all those comments as spam. Feel free to keep on doing that. But most importantly, and I mean this to you, 4chan, I need to know, sincerely, like, were you able to figure out the puzzle challenge? Because I thought it was pretty good. Like, the first one was pretty easy. It was in The Simpsons. But the second one, I thought that one would have gotten you for sure. Oh, subscribe and comment.
And it just fizzled. There was a little bit of action, and then it was just like, well, he's in on it, and he's asking us, and he's defined what we're doing, and he's... You know, from this point forward, if we participate, we're showing love to YouTube. And anyway, I owe that moment of my life to not just Justin, but also Ashley as well, because it was a team effort. And
I remember you being a lot more involved in my recollection of the events. But it was certainly harrowing, man. It was tense. I remember coaching Brian to seem more natural on camera because right. It only was going to be funny, or it only was going to work if he genuinely looked like he was like he absolutely didn't give a fuck, and this was like the lamest dumb shit that anyone's ever done.
Well, or I guess like set up in
I'm
a way where
real quick. I'm sorry, I gotta pee again.
Sure.
But this got serious. Let's play a game or something.
We got games.
We got games for you. But what, here, while he's taking a leak, I think watching it again, a big part of what made that work was defining, like, you have a choice. You can either stop or you can do it, but understand that if you continue to do it, I have defined it under these rules where I will personally derive a benefit from this point forward. And I don't know. Also, do you know what I realized? All of that, I probably shouldn't say this.
Then maybe don't. Maybe don't.
That's all documented, and all those comments are documented. And a lot of those accounts are still posting and living much more grown-up lives on YouTube.
Really?
So you're saying you have blackmail for a bunch of kids?
They're no longer kids. But
if they were kids then.
But if they participated in that raid and they are still using the same YouTube account, mm-hmm. which a lot of them are, as you peek in and see them beginning their young professional lives. Mm-hmm. Internet lives forever, people. That's all I'm saying.
Brian Brush is coming to take your jobs.
Nope.
Yeah, no. You have a compromat or compromat, whatever the Russian blackmail term is.
I just thought I just spent enough time poking in and be like, oh wait, these are real people, and of course some of them did it really for the lulz because they really were 14 and they thought it was funny at the time, but now they're 21 and they're going to Cornell. That's really weird to think about, you know, and also still using the same also it's wild to see the one, some of them are like trying to start channels, like, you know, you see them finally post their first video and it's like, hey guys, I'm gonna try to do some Minecraft tutorials, and I'm like look at you, you're trying to do a thing,
look at you, all right, whatever, typical Cornell bullshit, go Cuse.
Well, before we get into more flaming shot videos, we do have a lot of them. I wanted to pull this list, this doc. I don't know who exactly set it up and who the owner, I think it's probably RR who does all of the docs, but he made Brian Picks Fiesta Corner Hour, and it's oh my god, is this actually 43 pages? So
Oh, dear God.
Their images and shops and gifts of Brian from the years. Here we go.
Oh, God.
Slammed by the fallout of my irresponsible purchases after I got pounded by my midlife crisis turned gay for a red Jeep.
This is fucking great.
Oh, this is our puppy. I remember
is that
puppy
oh, Kepler,
at.
He's so tiny.
That's one of your live.
Where is that? Oh, that's got to be at, that's from a lecture.
Live streamed, though.
Oh, is that a bootleg live stream of my, I know where that's the penguin lecture.
Is that the penguin lecture in Columbus?
Did somebody
really?
Bootleg that and live stream it?
Oh, that's great.
It looks like it.
I mean, I wouldn't put it past you guys.
An arrow through the knee?
Arrow through the knee. Oh, that's right. That was when I periscoped out. I just said, I'm going to transmit 2 minutes of nothing but my left knee. And then you watch it begin, and then you just hear me chortling and laughing as I'm watching more hearts than ever before just pouring in on my shitty stream.
We got Albert Scamson. Grow weird like a real man. Nailed it. The flame suck. The notorious flame suck. That's a technical term. The flame suck. This was.
Oh goddamn! This
Tom
one.
Cruise.
Is yeah, this your Tom Cruise? Pretty good. Yeah, that's the Tom Cruise running.
A little
yeah.
more of that on Vladimir Putin.
Well, yeah. That's so Reddit. This is so applicable to my everyday life. I need to save this picture.
Wait, oh, you mean email? Oh, that's
oh,
good.
No, whenever
that's good
Brian
cropping.
Bitches about Reddit and how weird Reddit is,
yeah. No, that one. The second one that we said. Life is short. Have a magical three-way. MagicPassions.com. Oh,
wait,
man, that's old,
what is that from again?
God knows.
That might be an old ad read? I don't know. A Doctor Strange. Not a question mark.
Not a question. Just an exclamation.
The French fries.
I never know where to find it. I don't know what it's called. It's very difficult to find.
Diamond Club. Under Diamond Club original series. Marvel's Night Fister. And your fists are all bloody.
Wearing down them knuckles there.
It's Ratchet Face.
Oh,
and then the opening to Daredevil.
Wait, what? Hold on. What is that?
This is your
That's the opening to Daredevil.
Oh. Oh, how it went blind.
Oh, damn.
Oh,
we
yes!
Son of a bitch. We caught the end of a gif.
Okay. Oh, my God. The wet dream where I fucking came in the mouth of an ant alien.
I'm sorry. What?
I think you... That's one of those books you only need to read the title of.
No, you got it. You already got it, Mikey. You heard it. You heard enough.
Okay, cool.
Nailed
it.
Oh no, that's me losing my shit after. Just keep going.
Huh. Yeah, okay. Brian, Schmidt. That's right. Who was your running mate? Was it Fat?
Fat Rick Santorum.
Fat Rick Santorum. That's right.
Me, I love running with Brian. He's so great.
I'm done with triathlon.
I love eating pizza and running with Brian.
All right,
are those your Rick Santorum impressions?
Fat Rick.
There was a very weird. There was a weird thing where
it was like
for
Cosby,
reason,
but worse somehow.
No, it's after.
No, it was that. It was a very specific impression where after Rick Santorum ran for president the first time, and he lost, he just this was our character where he would go on a bender, a food bender, and he would just be very fat and like comically fat. And for whatever reason, not he'd have a southern accent now, despite the fact that he's from Pennsylvania. So, yeah, that was
Patrick Santorum. Hey.
You can't really see. It was a lot better when I didn't have this gigantic beard that you know could disguise my multiple chins.
Well, yeah, you were able to summon like between the camera trick of getting the right angle and having the exposed chins, you were able to manufacture briefly what looked like.
You know, guys, I thought I was gonna win. I was just. Hey, y'all.
Hey, guys.
Come
I think...
to my election, why don't you? Don't just, hey, later in life, I'm going to
oh,
run
up. Oh, dude, let me grab a beer. We got to play.
All right, we have more Flaming Shot Videros. If you don't know what this is, I don't know how you don't, because I explained it in the pre-show.
I think we got the old friends in here now. There were definitely a lot of folks hanging out. There we go. Listen, man, flaming shots. Everybody's doing them. Some people screw them up. We let everybody decide how they're getting screwed up.
That's right. We have got one here. Well, Brian just walked away. I don't know why he thought this explanation would take so long.
Well, we can just go ahead and start. Yeah. We can start.
Oh, this is great. Okay, this is Flaming Shot Fail from Brian Cranston. It's got 10,000.
Oh, shit! This is what he did before X-Files.
Whoa, he's got a really under-the-radar channel.
Yeah, only 2 subs. That's so weird.
For that many views, that is very weird, actually.
All right. So we got Flaming Shot Fail.
So this is back to this is the bread and butter of Flaming Shot Fails. Frat house, bunch of shirtless white people, backwards hats.
So I'm not sure if we've done this one yet. There's a chance this might be a repeatsies, but if it is, we've got many more to go.
It's hard to know.
Yeah.
Because they all look, I mean, sorry.
What's up, Mikey?
I need to know which is the one when they pour it, because he's going full chest. Like this is full chest.
So that would be there's 2 sides of it, right? Mm-hmm. It could be a Johnny Storm, which is just a part of their body lighting on fire, right? Or it could be a Mrs. Doubtfire, where it's specifically on the chest and they start patting it, or they throw
on the chest and they don't pat
Pete Brosnan. What was that?
What if they don't pat? What if they rub though?
Patting and rub.
I think this guy's gonna do a full on Doubtfire.
Oh, that's wow. My guess.
Full Doubtfire.
What do you think?
Full Doubtfire.
And if you in the chat room, let us know what you
credit
think.
Credit if he throws a piece of fruit at Pierce Brosnan.
Could happen.
It's a wooden by fruiting.
It's a drive by fruiting. I am going to say that this is a dulcim.
A dulcim. So he's gonna spit. Hands? Gas ball of fire.
Spit big fireball at the mouth.
Big fire. All right.
Which happens more often than you might think, because people they wind up doing the trumpet.
But I think I think we've discovered a wrinkle in the dulcim, in that if it kind of has to be cloudy, it has to be like vaporized a bit. Like if you look at the one that we did in the pre-show, she kind of just spat it out like in a stream.
Yeah.
I think there's kind of a subtlety there.
Oh, by the way, there is a fat Rick Santorum in the Twitch chat.
Is there?
Next Trollbot.
Is that a real
one? Hey, by
one?
The way, thanks for getting fucking booted, Trollbot.
No, he was in the wrong place at the wrong time. All right.
No, I know. It was collateral damage.
All right, here we go. Flaming Shot Fail from Brian Cranston. Click the button. There you go.
You're on. As I consume these flames. Help! Look at that shit!
Blue
Beard.
Oh!
It's not like the movies where when that happens, there's a record scratch and the music stops.
No.
Not like that at all.
In fact, also, that guy
no
dropped.
No Sleep Brooklyn just keeps happening while you burn to death.
That guy dropped his unlit cigarette to put out the fire. He could have knocked him out both in one.
Picks it back
one
up
sit.
And he's like, "Oh shit, I could have done 2 at once.
I could have lit this cigarette off your face." There's Fat Rick.
There's Fat Rick.
Oh jeez.
Oh, look at you, Justin. You're like
baby.
Right? All right, we got more.
Well, we both missed the first one, so it's fine.
We did. Yeah. Over 2 there. It did cut out before the inevitable Knight Rider, which is, of course, the holy grail of the Flaming Shot Challenge, which is somebody lights themselves on fire, gets into a car, and drives away.
That's right.
Which we
never It'll happened. Happen. It hasn't happened yet. The Knight Rider hasn't happened yet.
I can't believe
one that. One sub.
Yeah, so this is John IBR5, 1 subscriber, 6,604 views, 8 thumbs up, 0 thumbs down. Title is The Best Flaming 151 Shot Fail.
151.
151?
I was trying to give a cadence that my brain did not want to
enunciate. You sound like you're landing an aircraft, sir. Bacardi 151. Do you read? Bacardi 151.
Let's bring it on down for a landing.
All right.
This one hits the floor.
Like a kid at a football game?
I think this is a garage, possibly. Yeah,
you're probably right.
This one is a carry.
That looks like his mom and his sister behind him. So.
So Brian's saying a carry where someone else catches on fire.
No, well, no. I thought that was a fire starter. Yeah, I guess a fire starter. He's
fire starter's environment, carry is people.
Okay, got it. This is a fire starter, and the reason it is beloved by the eight people. This is me playing the Mikey game. I'm going to call the shot. The reason it's thumbs up is because they know this guy and he gave a big reaction. But he.
How many likes does the video have versus how many dislikes does
eight,
it have?
Eight likes, eight zero likes, dislikes. Zero dislikes. So I bet
you. You're going deep dog on this one. Like no one has seen this video before, ever.
Yeah.
God.
And those who have like it for a reason, and I don't
Justin,
think the reason.
Doesn't go before me.
I'm going to say Bluebeard. I think this is just an old fashioned Bluebeard.
I don't care about winning because it's about the journey. I need this boy to doubt fire. I need this boy to doubt fire.
I mean, listen, he's got a canvas to paint on. That's all I'm going to say.
So we got Brian saying it's going to be a fire starter.
By the way.
Or a carry.
Not insignificant detail is the fact that like 151 burns at a very different way than you know, that is the most flammable and most difficult to see of all the ways it could burn.
Yeah.
So it can escalate very, very quickly.
All right,
okay, wait. Can I change?
Yeah.
This guy's going to.
He's good at Dawson.
What is hands? Johnny Storm?
No, hands is Hadouken.
Hadouken.
He's gonna Ken or Ryu, depending right. on who your favorite.
Depending
character.
On what color his pants are.
Yeah, depending on whether you're like.
Yeah, I'm putting my money on a down.
Zem in the diamond says that this is going to ignite his cheeks, although thinks that there might also be a Doubtfire. Doubtfire seems to be
very specific.
Hashtag make Doubtfire happen again.
All right, here we go. The best flaming 151 shot.
Spence is killing
it.
Is.
I mean, that's a big title.
You gonna take that?
Yeah, I'm fucking taking it. Are you guys taking a video?
Yeah.
Are you guys taking a video?
Now notice that it's burning. This is the insidious thing because the flash point is so low, it burns. And in fact, like you could do it if you're in daylight. You could do a magic trick where you just have that thing burning and just like, you know, like, look at this giant PVC pipe. Watch me melt it with my brain. By the way, that's a good trick. I should do that on TV.
Hey, are you going to do how to take a flaming shot video on Modern Rogue?
Oh, God. Don't fuck that up, please.
I mean, it's so short. You just blow it out.
That would be kind of an epic video. I'll tell you what. We had internal discussions about the future of Modern Rogue, and we know that they like lots of content, and we talked about what we could do with the bandwidth that we have, ways to expand the bandwidth, and what down the road might look like if we ever get to a point where daily content is possible on the Modern Rogue, which is not the craziest thing on the planet.
No, in the longer term, it's not the craziest thing.
I could totally see a 30-second video being oh man, oh my God, we're gonna do a flaming shot. What's the right way to do a flaming shot?
So what if I mean, but
oh, you right, blow but, it out first, so that's what you do. Oh yeah, I was sorry.
But I mean, what if the point wasn't necessarily how you successfully take a flaming shot? Because obviously there is one safe way to do it, but rather where everybody in all these videos goes wrong, because I do think that there are a lot of different ways in which that they totally screw up, or at least you keep pointing them out whenever we watch these videos.
Oh my God! Hold on! So
you guys are adding so much suspense to this.
Can we do
No! I think
have these conversations.
Hold on! I think Justin is on the right track here. He's saying we could do a full 7-minute traditional style Modern Rogue episode where we break down all the fails. So we get all the highlights of showing all the fails, but as a professional fire eater, as the guy who literally wrote the book on it, can say specifically, this spark started this. This person didn't realize that the heat is over here. This is why, blah, blah, blah. God,
when this is a Knight Rider, it's going to be the best part of this show.
You need to get at least one of those people on the show with you to like sort of make up for the shot fail and to sort of make internet history.
I don't know. That was always my least favorite part. That to me was always the most when you talk down to someone.
Condescending?
No, I wasn't attempting to go there, but I see it.
That's a stupid
dad joke. This is dad joke.
There's also a weird Tosh.0 thing of like.
But that is what I dislike. Here's the funny part: is I actually didn't remember the word condescending, but I knew I could set you up and then fuck you. But yeah, that was my least favorite part about Tosh.0. But yeah, all right.
I wasn't trying to make them the joke, but yeah.
My thing's almost the opposite. I would feel weird about stealing the clips and would rather have the people on, but. All right, here we go.
Oh,
Junebug on Bob.
It's gonna be so hot. Are you taking a video?
Oh, yes, yeah. Because you're letting it sit so long. Yeah.
Lights are fucking out. Music stops. Oh, it's kind of
lights out.
Why did the music stop? Ominous.
Oh, Jesus Christ! Oh, Jesus Christ!
Directly into the microphone.
Oh!
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
First of all, I wasn't wrong.
Room's on fire?
Oh!
Oh!
So the very first.
Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh!
The very
oh
first.
Gosh. No, there was. You oh almost got it. You almost got it down the front.
Yeah, but this is definitely a Ghost Rider.
No,
that's a Ghost Rider.
But
yeah.
But here's the thing. I contest it.
Seems at the
it
end,
is
though.
It is an attempted Ghost Rider. He meant to go Ghost Rider. It failed to ignite, and instead, it was definitely a fire starter.
Well, if it's not a Ghost Rider,
look at
it's a Bluebeard.
It's right here. He spits it out.
Yeah. Weird. Oh, no, I know. It gets above the eyebrows, man. That's a Ghost Rider.
Yeah, that's a Ghost Rider. There is a fire starter element.
That's also a fire starter because he literally lit.
He started a dangerous fire.
Who is thumbs upping this video? What fucking ghouls?
It's the other six people in the garage.
Hello, the people in the video are the ones thumbing up the video.
We do need.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Because ultimately, it's up to the audience, and I feel like they need to decide who's right. In the fuzzy logic of like.
I mean, in a world where the winning literally doesn't matter more than
pay out all the ones that hit.
Fair enough.
Yeah. If you picked one of the ones that hit, you win. And if you call more than one,
The first one is extra kudos, but all of the ones that happen count.
Yeah, that's true.
Multiply in the other.
I just want everyone watching to feel like they have a. Increased
stake. Vryn would say you would pay out here. Ghost Rider, Bluebeard, Firestarter.
Yeah, but if you had guessed that it went in that order, I feel like you get like 1,000 points.
Although, I don't know. I feel like Ghost Rider or Bluebeard. I don't like Ghost Rider and Bluebeard being able to be called in the same video because, like, obviously, a Ghost Rider very rarely is going to not also include the Bluebeard.
They're a function of each other.
That chick last week. Oh, my God. That chick last week, remember?
What?
The one, who's like
with
entire
the
fucking.
Yeah.
That big, like, that news package.
Yeah.
All right, we got another one. This is from some filthy casuals, a real original name, guys. Yeah. It has 3,428 views and 9 likes, 0 dislikes. This is from March 2013, titled Flaming Shot Fail.
Dawson.
This is only 15 seconds long, so I don't even
What
want
is
to
it called when he lights his original copy of NSYNC's No Strings Attached on fire from middle school? I'm calling
that's,
it.
That's a 98
that's
degrees.
That's what he's doing.
That's 98 degrees.
That's called 198 degrees.
I see what you did there. So he has like a little Gatorade fire chaser or something.
Yeah, it's what it looks like. A almost full, like, he took a swig off the Gatorade first because he just needed to get some hydration.
Well, his electrolytes.
He's a smart drinker.
Yeah.
He understands.
This is Dhalsim. This has got to be Dhalsim.
Yep. That's two for Dhalsim.
Dhalsim seems to be a popular call there. I'm going to be more conservative and say Bluebeard.
Oh, Bluebeard. Okay. We see some doll seams in the chat. Open Body says blue beer. Doll seam.
Yeah, everybody in the chat, real quick, just so it's on the record, and we can hold you to it later.
Spin Dash 12 makes a good point. How big is this fucking stop sign, dude?
No, how small is this person?
It's really small.
You're asking the wrong person.
Look at the window, though.
Dalsim, Bluebeard, Bluebeard, Dalfire. Somebody just said virginity.
Well,
okay. Yeah. Good News 11 says definitely a 98 degrees. Definitely.
ICU says, I call, do chickens have large talons?
Oh, we have a fire crotch in here? A carry?
No way. No way on a
Although
fire crotch.
Although I think a 98 degrees is when you botch a fire shot and then publicly marry Jessica Simpson.
I will give you 10-1 odds on a fire crotch.
That's 100. He's not sitting down. You're not going to get a fire crotch without sitting down.
That's, well, it's, hey, man. Well,
you don't see what he's working with. Maybe he's got a real walk. I see a person who's about 105 pounds who's clearly three sheets to the grave is about to do this. So, yeah, I got a pretty good read.
By the way, keep in mind, normally we make all these calls with like a second or two of more data, but I think we're all locked in, right?
Yeah.
This one's going to happen very fast.
It's very short. Yeah. Right, yeah. Here we go. Flaming Chef Feo from Some Filthy Casuals.
What is the call?
All right,
okay, this
hold
is
on,
a
we
tough
have to
one.
Go to the slow-mo. We have to go to the slow-mo.
What was yours, Justin?
I had Bluebeard.
Well, it is definitely a Bluebeard.
Well, no.
Well,
so here's what I propose. If it goes above the eyebrows.
He went flame first.
Yeah, if it goes above the eyebrows, it is a Ghost Rider. If it's below the eyebrows, it's a Bluebeard.
Well, I propose
that's it on his glasses.
That's a Bluebeard.
Hold on,
right
hold on.
There. Oh shit, he is Ghost
See,
Rider.
See, I've here. Always assumed like all of these, like a Bluebeard is the lowest prerequisite to all of the higher levels. So it's like if he drinks it, and you cannot physically do a Dalsim without a Bluebeard.
But what I'm saying is that Bluebeard can evolve.
I see. So you're saying that
evolve
you
into a Ghost Rider. Yeah.
The Charmander.
Got it. Got it.
Got it.
All right, so yeah.
I would say that what we're seeing here is a Ghost Rider. It goes.
But here's the problem.
Oh, because it gets
on his glasses.
You can see
so
it on his glasses.
Quick.
Yeah. But here's the other thing. This is a really shitty Dalsim.
Well, I might.
It's not a Dalsim. It's not a Dalsim at
no,
all.
Look right there.
Oh, looks a little bit like a Dalsim.
Well, no, we talked about
Dalsim
this
is projectile.
While you were out of the room. Yeah, a Dalsim is a vaporized cloud.
Yeah.
That is more like a dragon's breath.
That is more like he opened his mouth and let the flaming liquid dribble out.
So
yeah,
just letting a bunch of flaming liquid fall out of your mouth and not project that out of your mouth. We need a name. What is
just real quick.
Yeah, that's not.
12 asking me if I'm at PAX and if you can buy me a flaming shot. The answer is yes, you can buy me a shot. You mean, no, I'm not doing a flaming shot at PAX.
Yeah, but can you do it like Paul Lind?
I'm not. God, no, he dad fired a little bit too.
Yeah,
there was a little bit there. All right, people are saying we do need a name for this. Is it Dragon Puke, Pete's Dragon?
No, no,
I mean,
Dragon
there could be references.
I do not feel like that needs a label because that is the way a fire starter happens, is that the liquid that is on fire in your mouth ends up on the floor. Has to get there somehow.
But we
got to
play by what the camera sees is my thing.
Well, to be honest, I think we whiffed on this one. It's not a Dalsim because we didn't get a Yoga Flame.
Oh yeah, y'all lose.
It's almost like this close to a Bluebeard, because like a Bluebeard where you just spat it out would be fine, but we saw above the eyebrows.
He's so got like a Cyclops thing. It just jumped onto his eye.
Yeah,
it did.
That's just new territory.
Man, and he's okay.
He's fine. Yeah.
God, I love his 70s
living room. I do think we need something for just letting it fall out of your mouth.
Okay, wait. Can I call one shot?
Yeah.
No, go back to the video where you were. When you see the whole living room, because this dude lives with his parents.
Yay. Oh, for real. Absolutely.
Yes.
I just had to call that shot.
I mean, look at that couch and tell me.
I mean, come on. Blue carpet.
Between you, me, and the wall,
dog.
I just kind of assumed that on all of them.
Wow.
Not the frat houses. The frat houses are different.
Yeah,
the brightest flaming shot casts the darkest shade.
So, whatever.
Zem in Diamond says, I don't know, Jerry. Literally every person dribbles it out of your mouth. All right. I'm with you.
But yeah, that's not a bad argument.
I was literally just trying to fish for another funny reference.
You guys got one more in you?
Oh, yeah.
We got one more. We can wrap it up on one more.
I'm going to skip that one because that's hard to tell. I've seen these. I've seen these, and that one was specifically hard to tell.
Hey, by the way, also, can I just give a big shout-out to Diamond Club for finding just an amazing crop? I feel like I was worried that we were getting to the end of the internet on flaming shot videos because we've rode this fucker pretty hard for a couple months now. Yeah. But thank you to everybody for being awesome with this.
Yeah, it's getting
They're finding stuff that no one has ever seen before. That's crazy. Yeah.
I know. Literally, somebody fucks up a flaming shot, uploads it, sends it to their friends, and we find it. It's like NSA level.
I thought this was Black Beard's channel. I was like, but it's Black
Beret. So this is, Black Beret's channel. They have 8 subscribers. This is 2,754 views, 4 thumbs up, 1 thumbs down.
Real quick.
Titles, How Not to Do a Flaming Shot.
Also, already double watermarked. So this
That's
is...
right. F6 already had funny...
Oh videos dot double ripped, UK.
Double uploaded, triple uploaded.
Also Everclear, which puts it in a whole different class. Because
also fisheye lens,
real quick.
Fisheye lens, yellow
fisheye. Fisheye lens.
What's that, Mike?
Can you explain the physics of Everclear? Because I don't light shots on fire.
Everclear
is
the maximum level. It is.
I understand what it is. I'm saying, what does it do to the
flaming
shot?
To the video, to my evaluation. Number one,
does it make it easier to light yourself on fire or not?
Oh, fucking yes. Yes to that. But also but because I'm a racist, it introduces a new or classist. I'm sorry. I'm classist. The moment I see an Everclear thing, the likelihood of wildly irresponsible, unprepared, activity skyrockets if I'm being Mitsula and trying to lay odds on this. All of a sudden, the moment I see Everclear, I start hearing the opening to Raiders of the Lost Ark and Anything Goes. And then, not Raiders.
Temple of Doom.
Temple
Moving
of Doom,
on.
Whatever.
Moving on. But, Temple of Doom.
But it is it's wildfire from Game of Thrones. It is the most flammable alcohol in existence.
All right.
That is allegedly sold for human consumption.
I'm calling it. All right. This is a Redbeard, a Dhalsim, and a Doubtfire.
Wow. A Redbeard, a Dhalsim, and a Doubtfire.
Man, now you realize you're swimming upstream.
I have literally 0 points, so the only way I can win is to call 3 and have them all hit.
Okay, so here's where I'm at. This is definitely a re-upload. Because of the multiple watermarks.
Yeah, no shit.
Super old, which will justify it possibly being a really good clip, despite having only 2,000 views. I'm gonna guess that the thumbs down is a vote against the re-uploadiness and not the quality of this clip, and I'm gonna say it's a full Johnny Storm.
Okay.
Ooh. All right, I'm gonna call this as. This is a, I'm with you, Brian, Johnny Storm, but I'm upping the ante. And I say right here tonight on Night Attacks post show, we see our first ever Roadrunner where he lights both of his feet on fire and runs out.
All right. I'm not, yes. And, my eyes just landed on the bottom of the page, and I'm glad I didn't read it until then because I could tell I might still be right.
Yeah.
But if you scroll down a little bit, look what I just saw.
We'll get to that.
Okay, all right.
Mikey, what was your bet again? I just want to get it down.
Redbeard, Doubtfire, Dhalsim.
Is a Redbeard different from a Bluebeard?
Sorry,
no.
Whatever. It's
okay.
No,
all right.
Same.
Whatever. It's
on
a beard.
The
it's a
depends
beard
on the
flame.
Heat of the flame. Good News 11 says, "What's it called when they set their friends on fire?" That's a carry.
That's a carry.
That's a carry.
All right, here we go.
Stop!
He dropped a lighter in it because he couldn't reach the liquor in the large shot.
But also, I had expected Russian. I'm not hearing Russian. my...
Oh, no, it's co.uk, right? It's a bunch of lads. Lads on tour.
Yeah, this
it's
sounds
ledge,
like
mate.
Southerners.
It's ledge.
I don't know.
You can't think of it.
This is not going to work.
That looks like
oh, it's American.
Yeah. Oh, they made that one. Like they made one in this glass concert. That was super huge, and they were like, "Oh no, we can't do this one." So they got a little,
oh my
this
God.
Like little goblet thing, this tiny goblet.
That's a jigger.
Yeah.
Try this again.
Oh. Bluebeard, Dalsam,
Dalsam,
fire!
Give me the shirt. Give me the shirt. Damn it!
Wait, he ran away. He ran away. Check his feet.
Hold on.
He ran point. Away. He ran away. Check his feet.
All right, let's get to the slow mo. The judges are going to look at the slow mo.
I got two
God,
of the three.
I nail
you got
a road
two.
Runner.
I got two.
You did get two. If Justin gets a road runner, like you get extra points for a new shot.
Dude, no. Yeah. You get to replace Bryce as the host if you get a road runner.
All right. So there's a Bluebeard.
Yep.
Very
yep.
obvious. You see him. What's this? Vaporize.
That's
oh.
that's a full-on Dalsam, by the way.
Classic Dalsam.
But not
a
only
classic
that.
Classic Dalsam.
Take a look at it again, because he doesn't light what the liquor in his mouth on fire.
No.
He, or,
oh my God.
Oh my God.
On the
he manages
shot.
To spit out the atomized Everclear.
Onto the flame.
And it does
shot.
Not combust until, in classic Fire Blast style, it reaches the other flame.
That's
wow.
right.
That's amazing. That's check his fucking feet.
Give me a second.
Get on his feet. He's running with lit feet.
He has a try. Diaper also.
It is on the counter, the corner of the counter though.
Yeah, so that's a fire starter. I don't
no,
see his
it's
feet.
Not a road runner. Oh, did he road run himself?
wait.
Oh, no. So close.
Wait, oh! No, that's a carpet.
Oh,
that's a carpet.
God.
That's a carpet.
Wow. So close to to a forced road runner on a compatriot. That's unreal.
Oh, that is how we play. Flaming shots, corner hour. Alrighty.
Who boy?
Who doggy? Boy howdy.
Boy. Man.
Best cult ever.
Who do we want to have on the show next week?
The young
we can
Pope.
Get be live in Austin. Okay. Hey, has Cargill cooled off enough?
Oh yeah, yeah. No, we could definitely. He actually publicly on Twitter was just like, we're chit-chatting, and he's like, "When are you gonna have me on Night Attack?" And I'm like, "Oh, okay." So
when?
Guess
you
it's
told,
been long
told
enough.
Us, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's
do?
Have him back on.
What do you guys want to do now? We can look at some videos. We only got through like half of these. This photo.
Yeah, keep there. Keep going. We'll go fast. I mean,
Brian Brushwood Monsters. Oh, this is your hottest fire.
My album.
Your album. This is we shot.
I did that on my phone.
You
oh,
did.
Really?
I did. Yeah. No. I forget what app it was. So, but yeah. No. I took a picture of I took that picture and did that that thing there.
That's fucking amazing.
This is a screenshot I took from the. Don't Drink and Drive ad that we shot.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Let's see. Oh,
yeah.
There's Harambe Brushwood. The regular.
Keep going. The rest are all them.
Oh, the old NSFW.
Man, what was the deal with the dunce cap?
No, it's for your birthday.
It's your party.
Oh, yeah.
It's a party hat.
I just party assumed hat. There's a bit right, where it's like,
rule.
Brian's done.
Surviving
the
cut. Wait, I don't get this.
That says vasectomy talk.
That's right. CNN Midlife Crisis hits Austin, Texas, local hard. Brushwood 42. Is that a
Jeep?
Dicks at night.
Also, Dicks at night.
Man, old mail route.
Wow, yeah, mail route.
Your Wayne's World.
Classics.
The Night of the Roxbury with Tom.
Those are not even photoshops. Those are actual scenes from the television show.
There's the Star Treks.
Those are always my favorite when they find uncanny ways to couch us in pre-existing traditional roles. I don't remember what that was about. Do you remember?
That's not even a photoshop. That's a real. That's yeah, a
that actually real. Happened.
Here's the fourth hour of the NSFW show.
Yeah.
Oh, it's the Today Show.
Yeah.
Wow, shocking skin tone match, though. For me and Hoda and him for Kathy Lee.
Yeah. That's MC Allergy, yep. The puppet?
Yeah.
Bonnie. Yeah.
As we know, Bonnie herself. Oh, by the way, how was that transmitted?
Austin.tv, yeah.
Never mind.
There's Justin doing his Bryce circa 2015 cosplay.
This one's pretty good. Like my hair in one of those photos, that when we did the tour of CNN, is a pretty dead ringer for Martin Friedman's
Never Ending Story. A smaller Harambe. Yeah.
Jesus.
Oh, that's the David Bowie.
This. All right, help me out here.
It's a romance book?
Maybe Admiral.
Admiral Nelson, maybe?
Is that Admiral Nelson?
Yeah, maybe. More Bowie.
More Bowie.
Yeah.
Did you see the replacement of Shark with
Knight?
Yeah,
Knight.
That's amazing.
Is that a commercial?
I don't know.
It looks like one of those.
Jib Jabs.
Oh no! I was gonna say the red, not Red Bull.
Red Tube, Pies. I think.
some pie face, some cream pies.
I vaguely remember that night. That was during shooting of the show.
Oh yeah, I was gonna say this looked like Shut Up and Play, but there's a van behind you.
That's Greg Grunberg's space where he had those Twitch guys for a while.
Oh Jesus.
Oh, God damn it.
Shirtless screen caps, of course.
What's a moment in her life?
Neon Demon?
No. That is...
Neon Demon is a...
Fuck, that's
movie.
Far Cry Dragon. Blood Dragon.
Blood Dragon.
Blood yeah. Dragon.
Oh my goodness.
Man. Yeah, that's back when I was confident.
Small shorts.
Yeah, tight. Yeah. Oh, my God. What little chicken legs you had.
I know. The this is also when I was shooting on vacation. Mm-hmm.
The first.
Hold on, look at the watch. You can tell by the watch. That's the Pebble original.
That's the black, yeah. With the.
So that means that would have been hacking the system time.
Yeah. Oh, you can also tell because the chat has got the 3D slant.
Oh, yeah.
You have sunscreen on your cheek.
That's human chism.
Cool.
That was at Tom's house, too.
Welcome to Hollywood.
Anus and Enos?
Wait, I'm sorry?
Or whoever.
Dude, whoever. That's the closest I've ever heard you say any words that felt like, whether I understood them or not, were racist in any way. Like, your disdain for fucking who the names of the fuckers were on that fucking show is palpable. I'm sorry. Is it Enos?
Is that a...
It's gotta be Jake
the Snake, Robert.
Yeah. Oh, because of Snake Dick.
Yeah, that was.
What is this?
That is the get up from the survivalist episode of Hack
of
the System.
Yeah.
But I love the idea that the only way this makes sense is if that's a segue I'm writing leading them all forward.
The moth.
The
oh,
moth.
God, the moth. No.
Moths to a flame.
The podcast awards.
God damn it.
Ain't nothing
like a 40-second birthday to remind you you're a piece of shit.
Yeah, that was when Brian forgot to thank me for an award that we won.
Literal garbage. Just human trash.
This is you cutting the line at Pink's, is that correct?
Sure, yeah. I totally cut the line, and that was all real, and those were...
Well, that's you. This is also your workout tape. What's this?
A butt.
That's just a good-looking pic of Prime.
Pounded in the butt.
It's a good Daniel Craig stand-in butt.
Yeah.
Oh. Hold on. Wait, is that the two nut cutters. Nut cutters, that's what it is. All right. Oh, my God.
Oh, my goodness. What are you doing to
Brian,
me?
Brad's very uncomfortable with physical...
Touching?
Contact of any kind.
Wait, is that a real thing?
True. Oh, yeah, no. He's very uncomfortable with physical contact.
No shit?
Yeah.
No, that's my favorite thing. That is a really fast way to let me know you're a buddy, is if you're the kind of guy Who just goes up and just starts rubbing the next guy's shoulders like, you got this, man. How you doing? You know, that kind of bro touching.
That's my go-to move.
Is that it? Just two hands? Like you're on a roller coaster?
Actually, ask anyone, I am the first to jump in on back rubs. That is true.
I am
gender agnostic about it. Also, I take issue with the caption on that last one. I feel like I have to say it because
he's butt raping.
Not awesome.
I mean, first of all, if I am, that's pretty impressive, right? Because that's a
sure.
Like logistically,
that's where snake dick came. By the way, your dick's gotten a lot of nicknames on this show.
Well, the problem is that they keep getting farther away from each other. We have like quantum physics and Newtonian physics. You know,
we have snake dick and toddler dick.
Yeah, right.
Someone sent this in.
Yeah, right on. No, but by the way, I think we've talked about this, but part of 2016 that's been really, really wonderful is getting a lot of. I don't think I'm talking out of school, but Penny's learned a lot of new ways to deal with uncomfortable situations, and a lot of it has come from doing occupational therapy sessions, which I never realized. Like, I just assumed everybody liked to be touched in the same way as I did. And at the age of 40, I finally find out, like, no. Like, you gotta loosen, you know, some people need to loosen up and feel this and get the blood pumping this way and all that stuff. Anyway. I learned a lesson.
Cool story.
Yeah,
man. Some people are getting touched. Some people aren't.
I'm saying touch people who like to be touched. It turns out I like to be touched.
What? And you're getting a back rub first to see you. So that's how that works.
Oh, shit.
Damn, it's getting a back rub, though.
Oh, shit. Fuck.
See that back rub? Oh, goddamn. Goddamn. His hands was like this, right? Like this? All day. All day, motherfuckers.
Do you guys want to gamble on a random, I mean, not right now, but in the future. Like, do you want to gamble, like, real money that we care enough about? Some amount of money that you actually care about on a chess boxing match?
Chess? Well, I don't know what that means, but I realize that spending 2 days in Vegas with both of you would be the greatest thing of all time.
Like,
oh, dude.
The chess boxing is a...
Shoot a movie about it. What?
It's a real sport where you do a round of boxing.
Okay.
And then you take off the gloves and you do 2 minutes of chess. And then you, once that time is up, you put on the gloves again and you go back to punching each other in the face. And then you sit back down. And the winner is determined by some amalgam of their performance in the boxing and in the chess.
I feel like I would take issue with the rules and how they decide to score that. Like, what? My OCD would take over.
can you give us just a taste? I know we're wrapping up here, but can you find us just a taste of chess boxing, Bryce? I'll be your best friend.
Oh, okay.
A dollop of chess boxing. Just a little.
Here is the World Chess Boxing Championships.
We're going to skip ahead.
No. Just jump in.
914,000 views.
3 minute round of boxing.
Yes.
Fought according to amateur rules. The contest proceeds with alternating rounds of chess and boxing. A fight is decided either through a knockout in the ring or by checkmate on the chessboard.
So it's whichever one happens first.
Now I'm in. Now I agree to the rules.
Runs out of time on his chess clock. If the chess results in a drawn game, then the overall contest is decided on points in the ring. And here we are in the opening chess round. Both men are being careful and avoiding the risk of giving his opponent an opening. Just like in boxing.
I'm trying Sashin to connect the two with things the to the gambit. Best of my ability.
Frank chooses the Slav defense. And by the way, those are not head guards, but headsets designed to blank out the running chess commentary provided for the audience.
Oh, wow. So it's like Hearthstone.
Then it's time to put away the chessboard.
Or like any
Each
other.
Each man now becomes his own fighting pawn as the gloves go on.
As the gloves come off.
Man to man battle.
Wait.
Just as they did at the chessboard, the two men are being careful, feeling each other out. The first attack just comes like from Nikolai, chess. Who crosses with his right hand and catches Frank with a glancing blow to the chin. Nikolai continues to show more aggression, while Frank is clearly wary of his younger opponent, and finally goes into a clinch. But Nikolai continues to press forward.
So this is only for gun runners to gamble on, right?
With a left hook and a straight.
Or maybe, and also podcast hosts.
The referee checks he's okay to continue, but Frank's wife looks concerned as her husband takes
that's not
three
part of
more
boxing, is
blows.
How concerned your wife looks.
For all his experience, no. Frank can't avoid
keep
being
the belt,
leads guy. His younger opponent.
The transition of them, like this is the moment that I love the most,
Nikolai
where it's like
to
they're
Frank
into
into
it.
The corner, but Frank shows his experience and boxing
have,
skills
have sort
to
of
turn the tables on Nikolai.
This moment right here.
I have
like,
external fear.
Well, let's, I guess, I don't know, play chess.
Here's my problem. They're not good at chess or boxing. So it's sort of like the worst of both worlds. The two boxers
have a minute to recover, and also it's like
to take off the gloves and to focus on their kings.
It makes more sense than I thought it was going to. Because at least
if they boxed and then played Crossfire, y'all get caught up in the Crossfire.
That was the thing where you shot all the balls at each other.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
With a porn attack on Frank's queen side.
Yeah, can we actually just go out on the Crossfire commercial? I feel like that's just the best way.
Yeah, no, that works.
That does bring it all back home.
Hey, do we have any friends at all?
I mean, number one, that kid in that leather jacket, man, he was literally everything I ever wanted to be when I was a kid watching that. Like,
if anyone knows what friends are streaming right now, you got 30 seconds before we
hang up. Who do we want to give a good how's your father to?
Yeah, just go in shouting Crossfire.
I have a Crossfire.
Do you?
Yeah, it's in my garage, I think. I can prove that I have it. I'm pretty sure I can grab it within 20 seconds.
Crossfire!
Oh my god, man. Cross motherfucking fire.
All right, the party's going. You guys got to say where. It better be fast, and you better scream Crossfire when you get there.
Oh, do we want to try Curly again, or is he going to be a fucking bitch about it?
No, just go. Just say, Curly, Crossfire! Drunk Kids Gaming. Just get on over there.
So just yell Crossfire, and then just we're going to host him here. Just run. We're not even going to say when we're going to go.
No,
just go. Right now.
Now is the moment. It's happening now.
Go. Crossfire. Crossfire ring.
Crossfire fuckers. Crossfire fuckers. Fuck. Crossfire.
It's hard to hold.
It's no longer my birthday. I used to be 41. Then I got real old and started having fun. Fuck you, Crossfire.